Today I'm going to be beading a porcupine quill in the shape of a feather. Some of the materials that we'll need are a porcupine quill, and the porcupine quill that I have, I've purchased at Halford's Hides, and the needles also, and the beads, and the thread. So I wouldn't recommend using this diameter of porcupine quill. It's a little bit too big. I would go a little bit smaller, but I'm going to use this one. And the needles I have are size 11 bead needle. I've got a long one and a short one. I recommend using the short one. It just makes it easier to poke through the porcupine quill. I've got a 6mm jump ring. I've got some Dynamo beading thread, and it's a size 3C. And I've got 6 colors of beads. They are size 11 also. Either 11 or 10. I think I have a little mixture here. So you need 6 colors, and we need approximately 90 centimeters of thread. I've pre-cut the thread already, and I will thread my needle. So when you're threading your needle, you want to pinch it up as close as you can between your thumb and your finger, and it just makes it easier to go through the hole of the beading needle. So when you pull it through, you're not going to make them even. You have to have a short one and a long one. You're not going to tie any knots. So we will be starting the beading. So I'm going to start at the top of the feather. I'll start with these two silver ones here. So to start, you will put on one silver bead, and then you'll measure down approximately 1 to 2 millimeters, about the distance from the center of the bead to the outside. That's how far you want to go down on your porcupine quill. So what I do is I use my thumb as a guide, my thumbnail, and I just gently push the needle through the quill. Pull through. I hang on to the silver bead with my thumb as I pull, and when you pull through, you're going to leave about 16 centimeter tail on the opposite side. You'll add one more silver bead and two red beads, and then you're going to go measure on the opposite side. I flip my fine quill, use my thumb as a guide, and push through again. You'll pull all the way through till that comes tight, and you will put on your next two red beads. And then you will go through that very first silver bead that you had put on, and through the hole that you already previously made, and the silver bead. And adjust your red beads so they're all on the next row, on row two. And then you're going to go back through the first row of red beads. When I'm doing this, I don't pull my thread super tight, because you don't want to squish your porcupine quill. So I just pull it gently, but not squishing. So then I'm going to go on to the second row of red. Put on two red. as the long thread and using my thumbnail as a guide. I will once again push through and put that. When I pull my needle through, I hang on to my beading and I jump. Feel a knot, just stop pulling, and usually people pull in the opposite direction, but not behind. The part that you're going to be repeating for each step is you'll be going back to the previous row to attach the next row. So you'll go back to your red, go through your whole red row. Those red beads for that row, and then you're going to go back through the new row that you just put on. So that's the step that you're going to repeat until you get to the bottom of your feather. I just realized that I do not have enough of the matte yellow, so I've got some shiny yellows, and I'm going to just show you how to take these beads off without backtracking with your needle. You wouldn't take your needle and go back through, because that would, you can catch your thread on the way through, and it sometimes makes a knot. So what I like to do is remove my needle and take this little ridge here of the thread and just pull it, and your beads will pop off. So that's an easy fix. So if you make any mistakes and you put the wrong bead on, it's easy to correct. So do it again once again, and then just continue. I'm going to turn my beading this way because I don't want to break my quill. So I'm going to have the beading in my, between my fingers even when I'm poking the ball. I'm still using my thumbnail as a guide. Too short, you just adjust it and decrease beads or add the amount you need at the tip. I'm going to do, because my needle is, the diameter of the needle is thick, I'm going to change needles because there's holes in the quill already. It just makes it easier to go through the holes again because this, the diameter of this needle is thinner. To the end of my feather, and it just so happens my thread came out on the same side as this thread, and that's okay. Sometimes it will come out on that side, sometimes it will come out on that side, but it's the same process. You're going to add your 6 silver beads. Make keychain or earrings. So whatever you want to do with it. It's a pendant. To attach the ring, I have two pairs of pliers, which is one that I like to